The Alpha Sessions with Ron Laver.
Welcome to another edition of Alpha Sessions. My name's Ron Laver, and with me today, I've got two artists. One is a returning friend of Alpha Sessions. It's Becky Lawrence. Hello, Becky.
Hello.
And with her today is Stuart Rolfe.
Hi.
Hello, Stuart.
Hi.
How are you keeping?
Very well, thank you. Thank you.
That's good. Now, the reason you're on together is you've got a single coming out, a duet, which we'll talk about in a little while. First of all, we'll just have a little chat generally. And I know you've got some music for us, both of you. But let's, if I may, turn to Becky first and say, you know, it's really nice to have you back on the show, Becky.
Oh, thank you. It's lovely to be back.
It's been a long time, hasn't it?
It has, yes.
And quite a bit of music under the bridge. And I guess it's been a pretty bad time the last few months for everybody. But I know you've had it particularly bad, haven't you? And
yeah, it's tested me, definitely. But there's light at the end of the tunnel now. So things are turning a corner, which is great. Fantastic.
That's good. And you're new music that you've done with Stuart, this is it like a bit of a fresh start for you?
Definitely. I think, you know, I needed to try and get back into, you know, what made me happy, what made me feel joyful, because a lot of that had just gone, you know, at the beginning of the year with all the amounts of things I had to deal with. So it was really nice just to get back into a project that was really fun to do. I think it was just the best kind of therapy I needed, really. And it was just so much fun to just work with Stu. So, yeah, I have to say thank you to him for that, because yeah, I don't know what else I might have done this year if I hadn't done it. So.
Well, the only other thing I was going to say with lockdown and everything, in a way, it did, I mean, once lockdown had eased a little bit, it did give you a chance to get back to your home, which for people that don't remember you from our earlier sessions, is the Isle of Man.
Yes.
And
I think it had been 18 months since I'd been back. And video chats are great, you know, getting to actually, you know, see my family, but to actually like not hug them for that long, that was hard. That was really tough.
Yeah, I know. We live around the corner from one of our daughters. And so we saw quite a bit of them, but on the doorstep, you know, at a bit of a distance. It was that sort of thing, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Really, really difficult seeing people and not being able to touch them. But anyway, you're looking good. And
thank you.
I've heard the new track and it's sounding good. So, yeah, nice to have you back on the scene again anyway.
Thank you.
And Stuart, we've not spoken to you before. So let's have a little bit of background. When did you get into music and country music in particular?
My background is as a session musician. I was a session musician for 22 years. And I worked alongside people like Mark Knopfler and things like that, which dragged me into sort of country music to start with. I just fell in love with it. So I continued in it and pursued session work as a sort of country music session, you know, player and stuff. And it just stayed like it, really. And left it.
And Mark, of course, is one of those who very much crosses over into, although he's known for Dire Straits originally, he's got heavily involved with country music, hasn't he?
Well, his roots were always in sort of folk country, sort of that sort of era, you know, that sort of genres. And and he's gone back to his roots, you know, and that's where I sort of fell into it.
Mm. And you say you're a session musician. I've seen names like Tim McGraw, Jason Aldean, and Miranda Lambert.
Yes,
that's not bad list, is it?
No, it's not. It's no, it's not a bad list. It's I was very privileged to get, you know, to play with sort of certain people, yeah, and some really high profile artists, and I was sort of very humbled to do that. You know,
and this is what I love about Stu. He's so humble about it, honestly. You have to kind of like really draw it out of him to like talk about it, which is lovely.
you're a rigid, I mean, you're a sing, you know, you're performing now as yourself, in your own right, should I say. But you were the lead singer in a band, weren't you, as well, for a while?
Yeah,
is the band still there, or
no? That's gone, long gone. I was, it was a rock cover band I played in. Yeah,
right.
Before that, which has a very bizarre name. Yeah, which was Chode in the Hole. So,
as you do.
Oh dear, that's fantastic. you're gonna. Stuart, you're both going to sing a track for us today. But Stuart, you're going to play one, I Fell For You.
That's right.
Can you tell us something about the track? Is it one you've written?
It's one that I co-wrote. I've been working with a chap in the States called Steve Guerin, to develop a bit more, well, a slightly different sound. And it's a brand new track. It hasn't been recorded yet. So... it's going to be the second time I've actually performed it.
All
so
right.
Be good. Yeah.
Great. And is it? Are you planning to release it as a single or on an album?
Well, I'm hoping that next year I'm going to release a new EP, so it'll be on there.
Right.
One of the singles. Yeah.
Okay. And what's the story behind it in terms of I Fell For You? Is this a love song or?
It's from a bloke's perspective of how he's talking about a girl that he's met, you know, how she came into his life, and he fell for her, really, and then by the end of the song he's married her.
Had a spirit like the wind, was a little bit wild and crazy, nothing tied me down. Man, those days are hazy. On that cold December night, girl, that's when you came. Yeah, right then and there, I knew my life had changed. 'Cause I fell for you, that adorable little smile. Sure, months later, managed to make you mine. Had me wrapped around your finger, spending all my time. From the beaches of Jamaica to the lights of the Vegas scene, all the signs were showing clearly that you were the one for me. Oh, I fell for you, pretty as a picture in the sun.
Marry me. Oh, I fell for you. The rest of my life, oh, I fell
The Alpha Sessions with Ron Laver.
Okay, so the reason you're on together is you're releasing a duet. Becky, tell me, when is that due to be released?
So it's out on Monday, the 15th of November.
Okay, and it's a cover of the Tim McGraw and Faith Hill track, I Need You. What was the thinking behind that in terms of getting that one recorded together?
So basically, Stu and I have been working together for well over a year now, vocal coaching wise. So I've actually been helping Stu with his vocals, because obviously, as he's mentioned, he used to be more of a session artist. So he wanted to kind of obviously be more of the front man, and just needed just a little bit more confidence in himself and his vocal ability. So we've been working on that together for the past year or so. And I said to him, look, we should work on something together, whether we write something or do a cover or, you know, just something just to get it out there. So that's when Stu actually came to me with the song I Need You. And to be honest, it's not one I'd ever actually listened to before. So as soon as I heard it, me just loving ballads, I was like, yes, 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 yes. This song is beautiful. Let's do it. So, yeah, that's kind of, you know, how we landed on that.
And Stuart, I don't think it's the first time you've been involved with that song, though, is it?
No. I worked on the re-release of it, really, with Tim McGraw and Faith Hill back in Nashville. And, I was one of the sort of composers for the next sort of era of it. But fell in love with it back then and always wanted to do something with it. And here we are.
That's very casually thrown in then. I was part of the...
See what I mean? See what I mean?
Well, what was that like?
Yeah. Sorry?
What was that like, being part of that?
It's an amazing experience, I have to say. It taught me a lot. To me, it was work at the time, you know. And I was, like I say, I was just lucky to be where I was. But the whole experience was just... Actually, to be honest, felt magical at the time. Mm. You know, it was so... They're such nice people, I have to say.
Yeah. And I guess, Becky, you know, he's being blasé about it, but I guess if you're a session musician and you're working with different artists, I guess, a lot, you know, you do get blasé with it as well, you know. It's you sort of get used to it.
But I think so, yeah. I don't think maybe, you know, what I try and think of is, you know, these people they're just people at the end of the day, but they're doing extraordinary things. So, you know, yes, it's great to have, you know, icons and people that you look up to and admire to, but they are just people like me and you. They are just doing things, you know, that are just extraordinary and fantastic. Mm. So, yeah, but it is, yeah, it's just, I do get a little bit like, he's worked with Tim McGraw or Faith Hill. Sometimes I'm sat there like, I can't actually believe this.
I mean, in my eyes, it's like the same as a mechanic working on a Bugatti or something like that. He's still a mechanic at the end of the day.
Mm. So true.
You know, it's just a car. It's still
your
car.
Job.
Yeah, exactly.
But am I right in saying that you also not only a session musician, but backed Tim McGraw?
I played the Country to Country 2018 on the Soul to Soul sessions, yeah. Mm. So we did the three venues with Country to Country. So that was...
Wow.
That was amazing, I have to say. That was mind-blowing at the time.
So you're pretty used to playing big crowds then?
From the back of the stage, yes.
So what's it like from the front of the stage then?
Scary. That's all I can... They can see you.
Yeah. You're not just the guy at the back with the guitar.
Exactly. Yeah, absolutely. It's a complete game changer. I mean, you used to always get an adrenaline rush going onto the stage, but now it's so much more heightened and everything else. But I enjoy it so much more as well, I have to say. I really do enjoy being out at the front.
Yeah. Well, that's good.
You know.
Just as well, really.
Well, yeah. Yep. Yep.
So... All right, Becky, you said, I was going to ask how you got together, but I mean, Becky, you say you've been vocal coaching Stuart now. But within that, how did you decide that, you know, you wanted to, that this was something? I mean, you must vocal coach quite a few people, but I don't think you record with them all the time. But, no. You know, so what? What brought this about? Was it Stuart twisting your arm or was your idea? Do you remember either of you where the idea
came?
He
bribed me with chocolate and cake. So basically, we just, throughout coaching and stuff, you know, I've got to know him as a person, and actually he's a really great friend. So, and because we're both within the country genre, it almost just lent itself to us actually getting together and doing, you know, recording something together. You know, a lot other of my clients and my students, they are a bit younger and they're doing all sorts of different genres and all sorts of wacky things. Whereas, you know, we're both in, although I, you know, don't pigeonhole myself to country, you know, that's where we both pretty much sit comfortably in. So it did just seem like a really natural, you know, progression to do. So, yeah.
And are there any plans for performing together, writing together maybe?
Well, we do actually have a gig this Saturday, so on the 13th in Chippenham. So we're actually going to be doing almost like a writer's round session with just the two of us.
All right.
A couple of acoustic tracks, and then we will perform the duet at the end. And then we'll just see what happens in the future. It'd be nice to write something together, wouldn't it?
It would, yeah. Very much so, yeah.
Yeah.
That sounds good. So well, happens. As I say, I've heard the single. Unfortunately, you can't do it for us today.
But, no.
But we'll just have to wait until it comes out and everyone can hear it. Yeah, but I have heard it and it is really good. I'm really impressed with it. So,
thank you,
Becky. Perhaps now you're gonna play a cover for us, aren't you?
I am. Yes. Yeah. So, you know, like I've mentioned, this year's been a bit. Kind of nearly a wipeout sort of music wise this year. I've really had to sort of focus on my mental health, but I've used that time, you know, some of that time a bit wisely just to learn some more covers on the guitar, because I don't, you know, most people who know me now know I only picked up the guitar last year, so I've had a bit of time to practice. So yeah, this, someone actually said to me, you know, I'd really love to hear you do this cover of you know, of this song. So I've just been, you know, sat and squirreling away and practicing, and it is a beautiful song. I think she's got an incredible voice and amazing talent. So, yeah, I'm just really happy to do my cover of Burning House by Cam.
Dream about a burning house. You were stuck inside, I couldn't get you out. I lay beside you and pulled you close, and the two of us went up in smoke. Love isn't all that it seems. I wish that I could go back in time be the one you thought you would find. Love isn't all that it seems I did you wrong. I'll stay here with you till the dream is gone. I've been sleepwalking, wandering all night, trying to take what's lost and broke, make it right. I've been sleepwalking, yeah, too close to the fire. It's the only place that I can hold you tight. In this burning house, the flames are getting bigger now. In this burning house, I could hold on to you. This burning house, no, I don't want to wake up in this burning house. I've been sleepwalking, yeah, wandering all night, trying to take what's lost and broke and make it right. I've been sleepwalking, yeah, too close to the fire. It's the only place that I can hold you tight in this burning house.
The Alpha Sessions with Ron Laver.
Okay, well, thanks both of you very much for coming on today. We really appreciate your time and wish you all the best with the new single, with the duet. We'll be watching progress carefully. Just remind us again, what was that date it's released?
November the 15th.
And I guess it will be on pre-sale.
It's on pre-sale now. Pre-save, pre-sale, yeah. Everywhere. Yeah.
Okay. Well, thank you both for your time, and we'll chat again sometime in the future.
Thanks, Ron.
Thank you ever so much.